Hi, welcome back to another edition of the Legislative Report. I'm New York State Senator Terry Gipson, and today I'm joined by Kathleen Durham, the Executive Director of the Eleanor Roosevelt Leadership Center at Val-Kill. Thanks for coming today.
Thank you so much for the invitation.
So there are a few organizations that we know about through the Roosevelts and the FDR Library, but how does your organization differ from the others?
Well, our organization differs from the others in that, number one, we're actually located on the Eleanor Roosevelt Historic Site, which is managed by the National Park Service. And we are probably the only organization that represents the voice and leadership principles of Eleanor Roosevelt in the sense that we inspire other people to actually learn about those, use them as a tool to take action in their communities. Okay. And we'll talk more about that when we talk about our programs.
So if someone would like to be a part of all the things that you have to offer, how would they apply? How are they chosen? How does that process work?
So obviously the name is the Eleanor Roosevelt Leadership Center is because we have programs built around leadership.
Right.
And human rights initiatives.
Okay.
So our first premier program is, of course, the Girls Leadership Worldwide, which serves girls from all around the world who come to the site in July every year. There are at least 36 girls in each session. A third of those girls come from the Hudson Valley for each session.
Okay.
And then girls come statewide from everywhere nationally, and this year, we actually have girls coming from Pakistan and South Africa and India and France,
about
13 countries. So yes, it's a very competitive process. They apply, and there are a group of people who get together and read these applications and decide which of these lucky people will actually be attending this program.
That's really interesting.
Yeah.
You know, it just occurred to me that a lot of our viewers might not really know what Val-Kill is. Should we just give them a brief overview of what is Val-Kill?
We should. Val-Kill is actually the home, was the home of Eleanor Roosevelt after Franklin died. Before that, it had been a furniture factory. Val-Kill Furniture, you may have heard of that.
Right.
When the president died, he, of course, willed that property to her. And she came back to Val-Kill, made it her home, said it was the first place that she actually came and felt that she had her own home. So when she died, her son sold everything like in a garage sale kind of style. And then some developers bought it and were turning it into condominiums.
Oh, wow.
Our organization saved the site. And as a result of that, in 1978, it was declared a historic site. The Eleanor Roosevelt Historic Site, first one ever for, and only one for a First Lady. Once that happened, the National Park Service had to take ownership of it. Part of that agreement is that our office exists, our organization exists, to provide the educational component for about Eleanor Roosevelt. That was the deal with our organization saving it, and then we have an agreement with the Park Service that we'll have a space there.
Well, that is amazing that your organization stepped forward to save this wonderful facility. It really is a treasure of the Hudson Valley. It's hard to believe that there was a risk of losing it.
Yes.
You know, I've been there several times and toured the facility. It's really in great condition. You've done a great job at renovating it. And you can really still kind of feel Eleanor's spirit kind of kicking around there. And what's great now is that you're continuing to use that site to train young women on how to be better leaders.
Absolutely.
But as you were mentioning before, it's also open to men as well and boys. So it's not just about women. You're trying to move into that area as well.
We are absolutely trying to move into program development for boys because if we want boys and men to really understand and embrace women as leaders, they've got to be sort of trained and ready to do that. So because a good leader, if they're developed within themselves, can then reach out and understand how to develop other people. But I want to go back and correct one thing that you said about the grounds and the preservation of it. Our organization has absolutely nothing to do with that. We are blessed to have the Park Service actually manage all of that. That is their job.
Okay.
We don't get involved. We just strictly do programming.
Thanks for that clarification.
You're welcome.
All right, thanks. So let's talk more about the programming.
Yes.
If I'm a young woman, which obviously I'm not, but if I want to go there and learn more about how to be a better leader, what kind of programs will I be taking when I go to this program here?
So in the next life, maybe you'll get to go as a girl, right?
I doubt that.
So the programs, it's a 9-day program, as I said before, and the girls stay at Vassar College. And the workshops are designed around human rights, the practice of leadership, the challenges of leadership, networking. They actually go to New York for 2 days where they visit women leaders. We're having a women's political panel that they will get to participate in while they're in New York. The programs in New York are actually arranged by Eleanor's great-granddaughters. Oh. So there are three of them that are still very much involved. And then, so the girls have an opportunity to visit these sites, like they go to the district attorney's office, for example. They go to the UN. And from these, they learn both enough to help them develop themselves, to get that confidence,
right,
to actually feel like they have a voice, and then how to use that. Because it's one thing to get all that training, but then if you leave and you don't have the tools on how to use that. So what we hear back is that the 9 days, which sounds awfully short to me, actually transforms these girls from, if they come as whiny young women, to women who are out there making a difference in their community.
Now, when they come, obviously they come from all over the world. Mm-hmm. Where do they stay and exactly where do the programs take place?
So they stay at Vassar College.
Okay.
We actually rent space from Vassar College. We have bus transportation that brings them back to the Eleanor Roosevelt Historic Site. That's where the base of the program is. And as I said, they do go to New York City for 2 days. We also do 1 day at Omega Institute.
Okay. In Rhinebeck.
In Rhinebeck.
Right.
God's country.
Right, my hometown. And it's important that you pointed out that you're not the Park Service and that the Park Service is a separate entity that does receive federal and state funding. You're primarily privately funded. So do you want to talk about that a bit?
I do. I'm so glad you asked me that. Because everyone thinks that we're funded by the National Park Service or the government because we happen to be located on the grounds. But no, the Park Service does provide the building that we're in. So this is good. We don't have to pay rent for the building. But it costs money to put on these programs. For example, each girl, it costs us $3,300 per girl to implement this program with all of the costs that we have to pay. So it's not money that we're keeping. It's actually money that we're paying out for the program per girl. There is a fee, and all girls can't pay that fee.
I see.
So we do a lot to raise scholarships for those girls who cannot.
Okay.
We are committed this year to giving out $41,000 plus. Actually, it's closer to $48,000 in scholarships. And so we raise money for that. We feel it's important to have a program that represents all of society so that it's open socioeconomically, politically, and religiously, you know, in all ways.
Right.
Yeah.
I think we actually have a picture of some of the girls that have gone through the program holding
excellent.
A picture of Eleanor.
Yeah.
They want to bring that up while we're talking. But I also want to ask you about a community college leadership program that you're starting.
Oh,
you want
yes.
to talk about that?
I do. It's very exciting. It's taken me two years to actually get this going. And I am so happy that first the president was talking about community colleges, and then the governor, of course, included it as always in his state of address.
Mm-hmm.
And then Chancellor Zimfer also has an emphasis on community colleges. Our program is launching in October of 2013. It's a pilot program. It's Orange Community College, Ulster, Dutchess, and Rockland. 36 students, 9 from each of the community colleges. And the program is designed to prepare these students to be leaders, either when they graduate or if they go into the workplace. It's a 2-year program. The first year is the learning, the skill building. And then the second year is actually where they apply what they've learned, either through a service project or if they're going directly into the workplace. Or to a 4-year college, they'll figure that out. There'll be somebody working with them to figure out what their interest is in applying that.
Okay. And in the Hudson Valley, Dutchess Community College will be a part of this? Is
yes,
that right?
Yes, Dutchess Community College,
okay.
Ulster, Orange, and Rockland.
Okay,
each,
that's great.
Yeah, it is. And I'm hopeful that when it's a success, that it will be...
I'm sure it will be.
It will go out to all of the community colleges in the state, of which I believe there are 30. And I think SUNY is really interested
in this.
Yes.
And it's a great program.
They've been working with us. SUNY New Paltz is really excited about it because it's a great feeder for them. And when you think about the impact that it can have on the workforce and for your colleges, it's great. Right.
I'm curious, do you stay in touch with the people that go through your program? How are they doing? How are the women that train in your program doing in their careers and their life?
Yeah, they're doing very well. Actually, there's one who's an attorney here in the Hudson Valley. The girls are, some of them right now have been accepted to Yale and Harvard and, of course, local schools. One just had a baby.
Wow.
They are all doing something. One of them has been nominated for something called the Peace Prize, which I never knew existed, that comes, should she win it, with a $50,000 honorarium. So.
Wow, that's incredible.
I know. We stay in touch right now through social media mostly.
Right.
And then through our newsletters.
How many years have you been doing this?
I came to work for the center in 2008, and I became their permanent director in September of 2008. So it feels like it's been forever, but it's been 5 years. But it's been a great experience because it's Eleanor Roosevelt.
Right.
You know, you can't go wrong there.
No, you can't. She was certainly an inspirational person and continues to be today through all the work that you do. Mm-hmm. Are there other things you'd like to talk about in terms of the influence this program has in the Hudson Valley and the region itself?
Yeah, I would like to, because one of the things that we hear often is when we say 73 girls or it's a leadership program, it's not, people don't get excited necessarily about that because we're not feeding people directly. But when you think about if you are really starting out and providing a foundation for girls who can go back to their schools, if there's an average of 500 students in a class, in a school, those girls are impacting those 500 students and then surrounding communities. So that number grows hugely.
Okay. And
then we, I believe, provide an economic benefit to the community because we're bringing people in who are visiting and eating and all of that. And our medal ceremony, which I didn't mention to you, which every year I think you came to it, we honor amazing people. For example, Hillary Clinton has gotten the award. Mm-hmm. Last year was Tina Brown.
Right.
And so through that, people worldwide find out about us and then want to visit the Hudson Valley.
That's great. Well, I'm certainly looking forward to working with you and your organization as we move forward, and I'm sure we're going to do some great things. You're already doing amazing things.
Thank you.
You're bringing a lot of revenue into the district. You're bringing a lot of new people into the district. You really provide a valuable service, and you do it in such a great location. It's great to see that being used for something.
Yeah.
And do you have a website or a phone number, anything you'd like to give out for anyone that's interested that might be listening?
We do. Our website is www.erleadership.org.
Okay.
And our phone number is 845-229-5302.
Okay. And do you want to just state the name of your organization
one
more time?
And the name of our organization is the Eleanor Roosevelt Leadership Center at Val-Kill. And do I have time to just clarify one thing?
Yes, sure.
People think we are only about being Democrats. That's not who Eleanor Roosevelt was.
That's right.
Eleanor Roosevelt was a public servant.
That's
so we embrace all parties.
Right.
I just wanted to make that
very important
very clear.
To clarify.
It's
That's
very
right.
Important.
So everyone should be feel welcome
yes.
to come and join.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously everyone should feel welcome to come and visit Val-Kill
Absolutely.
As well. Great. Well, thank you again for being here today. It's been a great pleasure. I'm sure the viewers enjoyed it. And we look forward to learning more about your center as you continue this great work. So
thanks
again. Thank you for joining us. I'm State Senator Terry Gipson representing Dutchess and Putnam County. And tune in next week for the next edition of Legislative Report.